cordially invited to one of our family arguments. It's open season on fathers. Of course, I don't expect everyone to know about family arguments, unless you happen to have a family. Last month, it was a fur stole. Last year, wall-to-wall carpeting. And with Junior in school and that daughter of mine, but they're not gonna win today. I'm just not gonna give in. Now, you listen to how I handle it. Jezebel is good enough. She's got four wheels, a roof over her head, and... Well, anyway, she's got a nice lived-in quality about her. Of course, they're kids. But Martha's old reliable herself. So I say to her, honey, you've got the common sense in this family. Now tell me, what do you think? And she answers,
the 1954 models are out.
Uh-oh. Here comes the real pressure artist. She'll roll her eyes and say, but Daddy dear, or maybe even worse. And there's the reserve team calling out signals against the meanest man in the world. But I'm not gonna give in easy. J.P. Mudrock has a mind of his own. Up until now, my baby thought I was a reasonable father. Oh, what's a fella gonna do? So I consented to look at new cars. I had a cute little gag all lined up. Pulled a wallet out of my pocket with a chain on it. The last time I bought a car, the character that waited on me, oh, wow. He wasn't really that bad. He just looked that way to me. But that sort couldn't work for a reliable dealer. Well, I feel better already. He's a good salesman. Tells you what you want to know about a car, and then lets you make up your own mind. That's what I like. Uh-oh. My buttons and bows department. That girl of mine likes sporty jobs. Just like her old dad. Always thinking of me. Or is she?
I dreamed I went riding in my very favorite convertible with my very favorite boyfriend.
Well, you can't stop a girl from dreaming. Now, my boy is different. He knows his old dad needs room for sample cases and for fishing trips. You can bet that's why he's sitting in that station wagon. He's thinking of the old man, all right.
I dreamed I borrowed Pop's station wagon for the weekend, and we loaded the rear up for Twin Pines in it. It still left us room to pick up Peggy and Jill for the dance. Boy, was it ever keen.
That's my boy. Before they get sold on a model that isn't just right for all of us, maybe I better talk to the boss. Even when I buy a suit for myself, well, if Martha isn't happy, neither am I. She knows what's best for our family. So I tell my friend, if he can satisfy the missus, then he's sold the Mudrocks. What I don't tell him is that she isn't easy to satisfy. As far as appearance is concerned, we all agree with sister. It's love at first sight. And you couldn't go wrong on any model we saw. But mother represents all the family, and she's a stickler when she makes up her mind. And I think she's decided what model I think is best. And now it's up to the salesman to prove that she's right. Right off the bat, he starts talking safety for the family. And one of the important features for safety is that in this car you can see everything. He proves you can. Then he starts telling us about some of the car's exclusive construction features. That body is really built for safety. Well, the missus can see at a glance he's right. But is she satisfied yet? Not my girl. She's on the inside now, looking at the seats like she was buying a living room sofa. The material's got to hit her eye. It's got to be strong and durable and the latest. And underneath it has to have quality too. Foam rubber and good spring construction. Then she stretches out to see if there's leg room. As for me, if I'm buying a new car, I want one of those gimmicks that, well, you know, it sort of goes under and over and, well, you know. I take a scientific view. And so I asked the salesman what kind of gadgets go with this car. He doesn't like the word gadgets. He says in any car I buy, I'll want convenience. For instance, this door lock is a safety convenience. Lock the door with a button, no fumbling for the keys. There's convenience, a dome light that turns on from the front or back seat. And I'll want automatic transmission and power steering. Now the salesman says I can have them on this car if I want them. If I want them, that's a laugh. Then he asked me if I've seen automatic window lifts. Sure, my boss has them on his limousine. But he doesn't have a push-button seat adjuster. I don't let the salesman know what I'm thinking, but I'm saying to myself, oh, wait a second, Mudrock, you're the guy with the chain on his wallet. What are you getting into? But then I remember, it doesn't have to be an expensive car. It should just have the best features of an expensive car. That's what to look for when you're buying a car scientifically. I want a car that's durable. The way to be sure of this is to buy a name with a long-range reputation. That's how to get top dollar when you're ready to sell or trade. The salesman tells us he's talked enough about the car's safety, performance, and economy. The beauty he doesn't mention because he sees we're still taking it in. He wants to stop telling and start proving.
You should have a demonstration ride.
I'm so excited I don't even recognize my own voice when I say...
Yes. Good. We'll go this way.
The salesman said the car you want should have an all-weather ignition system. All I wanted was to get my hands on that wheel. But he said, just sit and relax. Listen to the engine purr. How can I hear it when my heart won't stop pounding? But it's there because we're moving. My friend doesn't even have to mention how this new car handles. Now I get my chance behind the wheel. Talk about excitement. I took it up hills that I used to crawl up. I always wanted a car that would go up hills as easy as it comes down. Now is when I feel like a captain of a ship. Real control. Talk about getaway. This is without even trying. And this extra power will sure come in handy for passing other cars on the road. Real reserve power when I need it. All of a sudden, a crazy driver appears. I stop on a dime. What brakes? For a second, I thought my heart stopped. Even then, I couldn't hear the motor. One thing they kid me about is my parking. But if it's this easy to turn the wheel, just wait until I get a tight spot. I'll show. This is it. How do I know? The tough guy, the bear in the family with a lock on his wallet? Well, when J.P. Mudrock hears music, then I know this is it. Well, the story's really over. I'm sold. I'd never buy anything unless I was completely satisfied. Being a scientific fellow, I got a fair trade and reasonable payments. Of course, we started by going to a reputable dealer, and he satisfied us. It's these things that give you confidence, make you know you're buying the right car from the right people. Of course, my wife kept saying, the old car had four wheels, a roof, and a nice lived-in quality. But I convinced her that our new one would add just the touch we needed for the front of our house. But as long as you ask my advice on how to buy a car, I'd say, don't do anything. Not until you hear music.